everybody. Today we are going to discuss the energy types and energy levels of atoms and molecules. When radiations interact with matter, say for our purpose, that is substance, it radiates. When radiations interact with matter, it radiates into reflection, refraction, or diffraction. In other words, when radiations interact with the substance, at that time what happens? That is, molecule absorbs the energy and it undergoes excitation. Excitation means what? That is, we are going to see in this lecture, that is, how many excitations are possible by using number of radiations. Okay, but in the organic molecule, we will see the energy types due to the excitations. Okay, now how many excitations are possible? Okay, for that purpose we are going to see the excitations are by using number of radiations. Such as the radiations, we will consider here three radiations. Okay, how many radiations? Three radiations. Okay, first radiation is microwave radiations. Okay, second radiation is IR radiation, and third radiation is the electronic radiation. You know very well that is electronic radiations are nothing but the UV radiations. Okay, so one by one we will see the radiations in detail. So first of all, we will see the microwave radiations. Okay, which radiations? First we will see the microwave radiations. Please have attention on here. When molecule absorbs these microwave radiations, what happens? The number of excitations will occur in a molecule, or molecules undergoes excitations such as rotational excitations. Initially, when we call the microwave radiations, the energy required is very, very less. Energy equal to very less. Okay, it about 10^5 to 10^7. Okay, that is for microwave radiation. Second radiation are the IR radiations. Okay, when molecule absorbs IR radiations, at that time molecule undergoes excitation. Then which excitations in the molecule undergoes? When molecule absorbs IR radiations, the molecules undergoes vibrational excitations. Okay, vibrations. There are number of vibrations. But one thing must be noted, that is vibrational excitations must be accompanied by rotational excitation. Which excitations? Rotational excitation. So from this IR radiation, one thing must be clear, that is when molecule absorbs IR radiations, the molecule undergo excitations with vibrational excitations, and which are accompanied by the rotational excitation. Okay, but The energy required for this IR radiation is much more higher than that of microwave radiations. That is energy required for IR is higher than that of microwave radiations. Okay. Now third point is about electronic radiations. Okay, which point is there? Here the electronic radiations. Okay, third point, electronic radiations. Okay, as far as the name is suggests, electronic radiations, here the movement of an unpaired electron from a ground state level to a excited state level. Okay, therefore when we call upon the word electronic excitation, electronic radiations, it must be a UV radiations. That is when molecule absorbs UV radiations, it undergoes excitations. That is the electron can undergo ground state level into an excited state level, which is also called as higher energy state. That is electron from bonding molecular orbital to its anti-bonding molecular orbital. That is electron transfer from bonding molecular orbital from its anti-bonding molecular orbital. For this state, the energy required is very, very high. Energy required is very, very high. Okay. Therefore, when molecule absorbs UV radiations, at that time, number of excitation undergoes are, first is electronic excitation. Okay. Electronic excitation. Second is vibrational excitation, and third is rotational excitation. Therefore, we cannot resolve when molecule absorbs UV radiation, molecule can undergo excitation, number of excitations, electronic, vibrational and rotation. In this way, we get a clear band of number of atoms present in the molecule. We cannot resolve this band into a line. So which information we will get from these three points? Again, we will repeat it this. That is, when molecule absorbs radiations, the number of excitations depends upon the radiation with which molecule can absorb. That is, number of excitations depends upon number of radiation absorbed. Okay, in short, we will say that is in a microwave, which excitations can occur? That is rotational excitations. Okay, when IR radiations are used, that is vibrational excitation. Vibrational consists of vibrational plus rotational. And when we will use the electronic radiations such as UV radiations, we will get the molecule can undergo the excitations such as electronic plus vibrational plus rotational rotational excitations. Rotational excitation. Thus, you have clearly understood thus this number of rotations. Now we will see the energy levels. Which point we will see the energy levels? When molecule absorbs electromagnetic radiations, molecule can undergo the excitation, and different number of excitations are takes place. And this number of excitations with the energy level diagram in a molecule is known as molecular energy level diagram. Is known as molecular energy level diagram. We will see here in short what is the molecular energy level diagram. See here. E0, this is the ground state energy level, first, that is second and third. This consists of a V0. Okay, now second, this is called as E1. Okay, this E1 is called as excited energy levels. Okay, R1, R2, R3 and R4, R1, R2, R3, okay, here V0 consists of this, also V0, V1, okay, and this is above. Now see the energy level diagram for this molecule, okay. Where E0 stands for ground state electronic energy level. V0 stands for ground state vibrational energy level. And R1, R2, R3 are the rotational energy levels. Rotational energy levels. See here, what are the transitions of an electron can take place from one level to another level. Okay. See here. Okay. Now this is the molecular energy level diagram for a molecule by using the number of excitation levels. Which are number of excitation levels. Here E0 and E1 are stands for electronic energy levels. V0 and V1 are stands for vibrational energy levels, and small r1, small r2, small r3 are stands for rotational energy levels. My statement is that first is each and every electronic energy level is accompanied by vibrational energy level. Each electronic energy level is accompanied with a vibrational energy level. Also, each vibrational energy level is accompanied by a rotational energy level. That is, each vibrational energy level is accompanied by rotational energy level. And thus, in a molecular energy level diagram, all of the molecule energy is equal to electronic plus vibrational energy plus rotational energy. That is, when transition of an electron takes place from this vibrational to electronic energy level, rotational to rotational energy levels, and so on. Sometimes here the energy is absorbed to raise from bonding molecular orbital to antibonding molecular orbital. That is, round state is also called as bonding molecular orbital, and excited is also called as antibonding molecular orbital. Okay, bonding molecular orbital in short is, it is called as BMO. Antibonding molecular orbital is known as ABMO. Thus we have seen the energy levels for the molecules by using the electronic, vibrational and rotational energy level excitations. Okay, now we will discuss about the range for ultraviolet and visible spectroscopy. First of all, we will see why we will study this ultraviolet and visible spectroscopy. To understand the number of bonds which are double bond, DBs, and triple bonds present in the molecule, and which type of bonding present in a molecule, which type of conjugation present in a molecule. For that purpose, we have to see the ultraviolet and visible spectroscopy. This spectroscopy we will see in detail. First of all, UV radiations are absorbed by deuterium discharge lamp. Okay, now visible radiations are obtained by tungsten filament lamp. Okay, again I will repeat this, that is, UV radiations are absorbed by deuterium discharge lamp, while visible radiations are obtained by tungsten filament lamp. First of all, we will see the range for this UV radiations. Okay, range for UV visible spectroscopy. Okay, in this range, it consists of three parts. First is far UV, okay. Second is middle UV, that is main UV, okay. And third is far UV, middle UV and near UV. Okay, Now, far UV, okay. First of all, we will see from this point, that is from bottom, near UV, okay. What is the range? 100 to 200 nanometers, okay. Middle UV means, that is UV visible, range is what? That is 200 to 400 nanometer, and for far UV is equal to, what is the range? That is 400 to 800 nanometer. Okay, that is near UV is equal to 100 to 200 nanometer. Middle UV is equal to 200 to 400, and for far UV, that is called as visible region range, is equal to 400 to 800 nanometer. This is the range for UV visible spectroscopy. Now, for seeing this spectroscopy, we have to first attention on the Beer-Lambert's law. Which law? That is Beer-Lambert's law. Just we will see the outline for this law and we have to stop here. Okay. What is this law? When a beam of monochromatic light pass through a absorbing substance of a non-absorbing solvent, what happens? The intensity of transmitted light is decreases, and that decreasing intensity of transmitted light exponentially proportional to path length of absorbing medium. Again, I will repeat this. Generally, this law is called as Lambert's law. What is the statement of this Lambert's law? That is, when a beam of monochromatic light passes through an absorbing substance or absorbing medium, of a non-absorbing solvent. Underline this word, non-absorbing solvent. The intensity of transmitted light is decreases, and that decrease in intensity of transmitted light is directly proportional to, that is exponential with, path length of the absorbing medium. In the next lecture, we have to concentrate on this Pierce and Lambert's law, and we have to derive the relation